Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a Genius block. I have here an IC660BBA020 and I have the Genius block connected to an IC693BEM331. That's a bus controller. And incidentally, there's also an IC693CPU374 CPU and an IC693PWR330 power supply, and those are connected in a IC693CHS397 5 slot rack. So those are all the peripheral devices that I'm using currently, and of course Proficy Machine Edition software. And what I've done is I've configured the software with that CPU374 and a BEM331 to work with a 4-input, 2-output Genius block, analog Genius block. All right. So during this test, we're going to explain how to check for the I/O enabled light coming from the CPU and the BEM, how to use the handheld monitor and configure the device, how this should be powered up, and of course the physical inputs and outputs of this device and how to test them. So currently, I have it hooked up to a 24-volt power supply, as you can see coming in here. It's DC plus, DC minus, and then serial 1, serial 2, shield in and shield out. This is all going to and from the BEM331. And of course, I've got my monitor plugged in here so that I can communicate with the device. All right. So first things first, we have to make sure that the device is configured. All right. First, you need to know, typically from the factory, that the baud rate that it communicates at is 153.6K standard. That's ST. So I'm going to click OK. It's working, it's passed. Next thing I want to do is go into my configuration, F3, and program my block ID, which I've done, and I'll show you what I did. F1. Okay, so what you want to do here, for my test sake, you don't have to do this on yours, you may want to keep it the same, but for my test sake, I want to make sure that the block number matches what I have in Proficy Machine Edition. And just for a simple test, I'm just going to call it block number 1. So I have block number 1, and then again I'm going to check, I hit next, and I'm going to check my baud rate is standard, like I mentioned before. That's very important. All right, so block number 1, and then I'm going to go back to configuration, F2, configure block this time. This is set to the factory settings, so I'm going to go through these quickly. Report fault, input, output, yes, I do want to be able to report faults if there's an issue. Then here's something important. You want to set the range in which it's reading or giving power. So mine's set currently for 0 to 10 volts. So I'm going to do a voltage test first and then a milliamp test next. All right. So we hit next. My scaling is preset. If you are checking to see if your block is working, I would recommend that you leave your scaling the way it is, the way that it's been working in your plant or your factory or whatever application you're using it for. So I won't go too into that. Mine is automatically set to the factory standards. All right. And then next, filter, 128 milliseconds. Alarm input. My high and low alarm factory standard is negative 32,767 to a high of 32,767, that's the alarm range. Again, that's factory standard. If you have something different, that's fine. All right. Out 1, default 0. BSM present, again, factory standard, no. CPU redundancy, no central redundancy. Configuration protect. I have that off for the sake that I'm able to make changes. Although yours you may need to keep in a protected mode, so mine is currently disabled. Don't go by that. All right, next thing is we want to analyze the block. So we're going to go to F2. And again, I'm going to mention that I'm set up for 0 to 10 volts. So what I want to do is F1, monitor the block. And this gives me my two inputs, input number one and input number two. And then if I toggle with this arrow at F1, it shows me my other two inputs, input number three, input number four. All right, so we're going to start with one and two. All right, now what I've done here is I've set up a 3-volt battery in order to get a reading. Let me show you what I have here. This is just one of the memory batteries that we have. I've got the red and black for positive and negative. Now I'm going to take this away for just a second so you can see. What I want to do is press these leads against in and return. And I'm looking for a reading based on, it's going to be a different reading depending on what your the values of your settings for scaling is. All right, but you do want to see a reading, and if all the values of all your settings are the same, all your readings should be the same, if you follow. Okay, another tip is make sure that all these screws are screwed down. They have to be screwed down tightly, because there'll be times where if it's loose and it's not making contact, you go to press and get a read a value, you're not going to get anything because there's basically a loose connection. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and press on this, and what I want you to do is take a look at the reading in my monitor. All right, so again, in and return, and I'm looking at input number one. If you look at the monitor, it's 6179. Now all my scaling is the same for every channel. So I'm looking at I'm looking for a similar figure for input number two. All right. 6179. All right, so I've got two channels that are reading the same. That's a good sign. Channel 3, 6,172, still very good. Channel 4, input and return. Excellent. So that's good. Next thing you want to check, since we're on voltage, again, I'm on the monitor, is the output. All right. So I'm going to go back one. I'm going to click menu. And F2 monitor. Now we're going to go, this is input 1, input 2, 3, 4, output 1. Now I can force a value in there. As you remember, my high range was 32,000. So what I'm going to do is force F2, 32,000 for a round figure. I'm going to click enter. Now that is forced into the system. Now I'm going to go to output 2, same thing. F2, force, 32,000. F3, enter. Now that value's in there. I'm going to go back to 1. Here's what I'm going to do. I have here a multimeter that we use in the test lab. And I've currently got it set for voltage, DC. And as you recall, we have set the block for 0 to 10 volts DC every channel. And what I want to do is connect these two leads to where it says on the block common, voltage out, output 1. And then the next one I want to check is common, my black lead or negative lead. And then my red and positive lead goes to voltage out, output 2, the very last terminal. So again, black is on common, red or positive is on voltage out. And I'm going to show you the results of that in just a second here. So, common voltage out, and I'm looking for a value of about 10 volts. So hopefully you folks can see this all right. Show you that one more time. The next thing I want to do is on the handheld monitor, I'm going to click release, which is F4. And what I'm doing there is I'm trying to make sure that I'm able to release that value. And I should get a reading of 0. And I do. Okay. Next input again. Ten volts. See if I can get my hands on that. We have 10 volts DC. I'm going to hit release. I've released the value and now I'm back down to 0. So that's important to make sure that the output can be on or off at whatever value that you've put in. All right, so next thing we quickly want to test here is that we can do all of the same thing with milliamps. All right, one other thing I wanted to point out, actually, before I go any further, the IO enabled light is on, and that's because I have the IC693BEM331 set to this being a 4 input, 2 output analog block, and it is configured as block number 1. And once I've got the CPU into run mode, I've been able to enable, as I can tell by this indicated LED here, enable this block. What that also means is that this port is communicating, it's working properly, and if I want to, I can force the inputs and outputs off or on using Proficy Machine Edition. All right. Okay, so back to the handheld monitor. This is a IC660HHM handheld monitor, 501. Go to configuration, F2, configure block. Here's my range. I'm going to toggle 1, 2, 4 to 20 milliamp and hit enter. I have to do that with all of the inputs and outputs. You could toggle using F1 to throughout all the channels. So okay, so these have all been entered, and I'm going to go back to home, F2, F1 monitor block. Now, I have a 4 to 20 milliamp generator. So this generates a very small milliamp value. I have 2 probes that I'm going to use to connect to my inputs. I'm going to be using the same inputs and outputs, of course, as I was using for voltage. They connect through the same area, all right? So for the inputs, input and return, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then when we get to the outputs, it's a little bit different. We're going to be touching I plus and I minus and I plus and I minus to the corresponding outputs. So right now, I'm touching the leads to the input and return of input number 1. And it's giving me a value of 24,522. Input and return number 2. 24,522, that's excellent. I'm going to toggle using F1 to my inputs 3 and 4. $24,536, still definitely within the range. And input number 4. $24,536, that's good. That's a very consistent number, so that's what we want to see. Again, I have factory scaling. Please keep that in mind. Next thing is we want to check our outputs. So go back to the handheld monitor. All right, I'm going to go to Home, Analyze, Monitor, F2. And we go, using the F1 key, we go over to 1, 2, 3, 4. Output number 1, same thing, I'm going to put in that 32,000 value by hitting Force, F2, 32,000, enter. Force, 32,000, enter. All right, so now we have values in there. Go back to number 1 first. I'm going to take my multimeter again, switch it to milliamp reading, direct current, DC. Okay, as a reminder, output for milliamp is I plus and I negative, I positive, I negative, and we want to touch the probes to those terminals, all right? So, first we're going to test output 1. We're looking for a value of about 20 milliamps. So, yep, so if you can read that, it's 21. The next thing I'm going to do is hit release and make sure that we can shut that off. And 0.005 or 0.001 is a common number when it's in the off position. All right, we're going to go over to output number 2. Very consistent here, very good. 21 milliamp. All right, and then I'm going to release that. Make sure we can get back to that zero figure or as close to it as possible, 0.005, excellent, very consistent. So that concludes an entire test of a BBA020. If for any reason you go to power it up and you don't have any lights on at all, obviously there's something definitely wrong with the Genius block, and that is something that we do typically repair here. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured devices. So if that's something that interests you or you need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.